Hi guys, Jordan with Motion Array, and if you're watching this video, you've probably downloaded one of our photo video templates, and if so, awesome! We hope you really like it. But there's a chance that you saw an awesome looking template, downloaded it, opened it up, and then said, what do I do now? Where do I actually go from here? If that's you, well then you're in the right place, because we're gonna open up After Effects and take a look at how to use these templates together. So right now, I have the downloaded file from a photo video template. And for reference, it's this one here. If you're interested, I've linked it in the description below. But let's start off by locating the After Effects file, double-clicking it, and now After Effects will pop up, and from here, you should be greeted with the template, but without any pictures or videos inside. This is not an accident. These templates are designed for you to be able to insert your own media. And the first place that you should look is in the project window over here. Each template will have slightly different nuances, but they should all have a similar layout. You should have some sort of an edit folder, a final folder, and you may or may not have an other folder. For the purpose of this tutorial on basic usage, you don't want to worry about these two. Just the edit folder is what we want to focus on. Open it up, and here we're greeted by three new folders. And each of these will tell you a different area that you can edit: color, media, and text. We're gonna first take a look at how to add media, then how to work with text, and finally we'll end with how to change color and other aesthetic elements. So to start, how do you actually place your own media into this composition? Well, if you drop down the media folder here, you should see a variety of different compositions labeled media 1, media 2, media 3, etc. What these are the placeholders for each picture in the order that they appear. So if we skim forward here, we can see the first spot where a picture is supposed to be. And if it's the first place, then Media 1 is the slot where we know this picture will show up. So how do you actually add in your own media? Well, you first have to import your own media. So let's start by going to our project window, and you can either double-click or right-click and go to Import File. From here, you can find on your computer all of the different pictures or videos that you want to include in your project. I would suggest having a folder ahead of time where you've compiled everything together, so you simply have to find that one folder and then select everything to import at once. Then click Import and the files will be available inside of After Effects. Nice! And here we can see that if we click on one of these clips, we can get a sense for what each picture or video is in the top left corner here. So find the picture that you want to appear first, and then you can add it one of two ways. Either drag it right on top of the composition for Media 1, or double-click on Media 1, and then drag it down here into the composition. We can see that right off the bat, our picture is too large, so let's decrease the size. If you hold down Shift while dragging these corners here, the perspective of the picture won't change at all, it'll just get smaller. Likewise, now I just want to move the picture up, but I like how it's centered. So hold Shift again and move it up to prevent it from moving at all side to side. Nice! So how does this look in our project? Well, let's go back to our main composition and see. Likely, it'll either be the composition here on the far left, but if you're not sure, you can always go back to the final folder and double-click the full composition. In our example, both of these two are the same, but they just show different resolutions of the same project. I'm gonna go with 1080. And boom, there it is! That already looks awesome. So I'm gonna quickly go through that same process with a couple more pieces of content. And honestly, it can be this fast to add new elements. Now we have three pictures in a row. And here's another great part. If you want to add a video, the process is just the same. Now our project has both photos and videos. Great, so our media's in place, but the text doesn't say what we want it to say. Well, this process works very much the same as adding new media. Drop down the text folder, and each composition is in order with each piece of text that comes into frame. So if we go back to the very beginning, the first piece of text should be text 1. And sure enough, when we double-click text 1, we can change that piece of text. Let's title it Motion Array. Double-click the text here, or on the layer here to highlight your text. Now, make it say whatever you want. And I'm also just going to give it a new font and increase its size a little bit. Great! Now, if we go back to our main composition, we can see that our text immediately takes form. But let's go back here to our text composition for 1 second. We can see that there's a box around our text here that's not the normal shape or size of the composition we normally work with inside of After Effects. Basically, what this is showing us is where the safe areas of our text can be. Anything inside of this box will show up normally, but if we take it to the edge here and have part of it cut off, this is what it will look like inside of our composition. So just keep that in mind. Okay, so we've learned how to work with inserting media and also how to change text. But now how do we control some of the other elements in our project, like color? Well, that's where we go here to the color tab and double click this composition. And we can see here that we have only one layer. And when we drop down the effects panel, we can see that there's actually a lot of different parameters that we can address. And if we go up to the project window here and switch to effect controls, we can see a very similar layout. Now, depending on your template, you may have either more or less options to play around with. But a good place to start with each of them is to look at the name and then do a test to see what it impacts. So I can see here that this one says background color 1. And when we drop it down, there's a color swatch available for us. Based on this evidence, I'm going to say that it changes the background color of our template. Let's just see what it looks like when we change it to something different. Let's make it cherry red. Okay, so now we can see what the color change is affecting. It's not actually making a solid color difference, it's actually only impacting specific areas. So I'm going to assume that background color 2 will control some of the areas that background color 1 didn't. And sure enough, this is what happens. But if you didn't want your composition to look like this, that's okay. By hitting Ctrl or Command Z, you can undo your most recent decisions. Nice, no harm done. And now I can confidently go forward and make some changes that I want to see based on my own personal preference. I would also highly encourage you to do the same with testing any other sections that you're not entirely sure of what they do. Some of them might require a little bit of testing, and others might be more self-explanatory. Like here we can see intro and outro color text, as well as general color text. You get a pretty clear idea of what it's going to impact. Parameters like color will be pretty consistent between most templates, but we bring up some others because there's going to be some that are specific to the template that you've chosen, like this parameter here, corner roundness. If we test it out to see what it is, we can see that it's literally controlling the roundness of each of these shape corners here. This is a very specific effect to this particular project, and you may find that each individual project has its own unique elements that you can play around with. So feel free to experiment and see how you can make each of these templates truly your own. But guys, that's it for me. If you guys like this video, hit the like button, subscribe, or even share this video with a fellow video editor friend. Also, because you're watching this on YouTube, Motion Array is offering 20% off your first month subscription when you sign up. If you're interested, the link is in the description below. Check it out. But guys, that's it for me. Thank you so much for watching, and I can't wait to see you in the next video.